who gives this woman in marriage? Okay. On behalf of the family, I want to welcome each and every one of you. We're here today to witness a sacred service that I know they're glad that you're here. And I just ask you that you be much in prayer for them as they start their life together. And it's so important for you all to help them remember the things that's important in their lives. Marriage is a sacred and solemn between a man and a woman. And the Bible says in the book of Ephesians, for this cause, and that's what we're talking about this morning, this cause, for this cause shall a man leave his father and mother and join unto his wife, and they shall be one flesh. Let's pray. Oh, kind and gracious Heavenly Father, God, we're so thankful for these that's come today, and God, especially this new couple. God, I just ask that you bless them in a mighty way. Help them along life's way, Lord, and may they turn to you for strength and encouragement. God, we praise you, and what a joyous time this can be. Thank you so much, Lord, for all that you do. In Christ's name, we pray. Amen. Okay, I'm going to start with you. All right, Brian. I want you to repeat after me. I promise to keep you.
I promise to keep you.
For as long as we live.
For as long as we live.
Through good times.
Through good times.
Bad times.
Bad times.
Through wealth.
Through wealth.
And riches.
And riches.
So help me God.
Help me.
Summer, do you take this man who stands in front of you as your lawful wedded husband?
I do.
To honor, to cherish, to help. Repeat after me. I, Summer. Take this man.
Take this man.
Ty.
To
be my lawful wedded husband.
For better or for worse.
For richer or for poor.
For richer or for poor.
Until death does us part. All righty. Where I need the rings.
It's your time, buddy.
Okay, Ty, I'm going to let you do this for me, if you would, please. Rings are a symbol of a round circle with no beginning and no end. And that's what they're going to do right now. They're going to take their wedding bands and they're going to exchange one with the other. And that's to show their love that they have one for another. So, Ty, put your ring on Summer, please. Okay. Ty, repeat after me. This ring is a symbol of my love.
This ring is a symbol of my love.
My commitment.
My vows.
That I have made this day with her. With this ring, I do wed. Summer, put the ring on me, please. I, Summer.
With this ring.
That he's placed on my hand. I solemnly swear. To be loving. Faithful. Through good times.
Through bad.
Rich.
Poor.
And I'll always be there to support.
And I'll always be there to support you.
All righty. Let's bow our heads. Oh, kind and gracious Heavenly Father, Lord, I thank you so much for this congregation of people that's come, family and friends, to witness this today as we begin to make one flesh. And God, we ask you today that these people will remember what the Bible tells us over in the book of Mark, and I think it's about the 9th verse, and it says, "Where or what therefore God hath joined together, let no man put asunder. Okay, thank you, amen. And now, by the power invested in me and the state of Florida, and most importantly, through God Almighty, I pronounce you now man and wife. You may kiss your bride. Woo! So I'll stand if you would, please.
Game over, buddy. No more choices without asking first.
Hey, family and friends, let's please welcome Mr. and Mrs. Ty Britt.
Thank you. our father-daughter dance.
Everybody, if we could, bless this food. Lord, thank you so much for this day. Thank you for bringing us together. Everybody here is blessed, and we just can't thank you enough for everything you've done. And we thank you for going before us to prepare a way. Just ask you to bless this food, bless everybody here, bless this new marriage, and everything that's great to come. And we just thank you in Jesus' name and pray. Amen.
Maybe the sun will spread your joy to the ones who lost their hope.
For those who did not know that by now, you're probably at the wrong wedding. No, I'm joking. I'm going to make this speech very short and sweet, though. I'm not much for public speaking, and the longer I'm up here, There's a better chance of me possibly crying and throwing up. So I'll make this quick. I want to thank you guys both for having me at your wedding. It is truly an honor and a privilege, and it's something by far I will never forget. There's by far a thousand stories I could tell up here tonight.
Tell them! Come on, tell them!
But honestly, I could have picked this one. After all of being us together for just about every weekend, for years on end, it tends to create a lot of memories.
You got this!
Hey, BBFB! Come on.
Yeah, good man. One thing is for sure, those memories are something we will never forget, and that's honestly all that matters.
What if the world had more?
With that being said, I hope today was everything you guys wanted. I know for a fact you two will go far. Hold on. Go far and do great in life. I wish you two nothing but the best. Nothing but the absolute best. And a long-lasting, healthy marriage. And no matter what, I will always have your back.
Tiffany, for those of you who may not know me, I am Summer's sister and also her co-maid of honor. For those of you who do know me, I'm sure you're ready for the shit show to get going. Who ever put me up here trying to explain what these two's love stories been like when I clearly know very little about love? Sorry, Gage. But anyways, I'll do the best I can to explain what these two have shown me over the past 7 years or so. So I'll start by going way back to when Summer and I first started going to church together. More specifically, we started going to the First Baptist Church of Akawaha, and looking at us now, who would have thought we ever went to one of those? And Summer instantly started making really good friends with youth group kids, but more specifically with Tyner's family really quick. And I'm not going to lie and say that I was some great wait moment for my sister. I definitely knew he liked her, she liked him, but I still had a mental competition of whose face I could turn more red every time I walked into her room they were together in. But I think that the main reason I did that was because for the first time, somehow, somebody had been more fond of my sister than I had been. Because I knew if there was a room that Ty and I were both in, I was 110% chopped liver. And that's okay. But fast forward to about 6 years ago, when Ty finally summed up the courage to ask my dad for permission to be Summer's boyfriend. And of course, that little kiss ass, my dad said yes, with no hesitation. But within dating for just a couple of years, these two became bonded. And I really had a hard time trying to come up with a story that showed the true love and bond that these guys had way back when. But here's what I got. So one day, a Summer, my dad, and I ate with Ty on his lunch break at Ale House. I know you know where this is going. We did that a lot. We'd eat with Ty when he was working in his lunch break, when he was in construction, doing work and whatnot. And then we'd head home, and he would go back to work. This day was a little different, though. So we ate, chit-chatted at Ale House. He went back to work, and we went back home. But it wasn't 5 minutes after leaving the Ale House parking lot, Summer would not stop talking about something not being okay with Ty. And my dad and I both said it was okay, he could go 5 minutes without texting you, it was not a big deal, but she wouldn't stop. All the way home, it was about 20 minutes, and we finally got to the dirt road, and Mr. Levi, Ty's father, called up Summer and said that Ty had been in a severe car accident and was in the ICU in critical care. And that instant still just gives me goosebumps because she just knew. It wasn't 5 miles or maybe 10 miles to get a drive back to work. She knew long before his coworkers, the people that were working on the work site with him knew that anything was wrong with him, Summer wouldn't stop and wouldn't shut up about it. She knew before anybody else did. And the way these two have just known each other and clicked, even way back when, I think is truly the most purest way to explain what love is. But after that call that Summer received from Mr. Levi, as my entire family was brought to tears in the ICU waiting room and we were being told that Ty was lucky to even still be breathing, I came to a realization. I could no longer call Ty and refer to him as that punk-ass, annoying-ass kid dating my sister to church. I came to the realization that he was becoming my family, and more importantly, the entire Britt family was becoming my family. And that was official, and I can honestly say I could not be happier to call Ty Robert Britt my family and my brother-in-law. And I'm so proud of the both of you and what you guys have accomplished together. So if everyone will please raise a glass to the bride and groom, may you forever and ever keep that instinct about one another. Cheers.
All right. Good evening, everyone. For those of you who don't know me, my name is Kristen. I'm one of Summer's best friends and also maybe one I got lucky enough to share that role with Tiff tonight.
Yeah!
I want to start by saying thank you all for being here tonight to help celebrate two of the most fun-loving people I know. Although I've only known Summer for a few years now, when you share a relationship, a friendship like ours, you share more than just memories. And boy, do we have some really interesting ones. I won't tell any because they're all really bad. Summer, I want you to know you are like a sister to me. I am so proud of you and can't wait for this new chapter in your life. Again, bad idea. Over the years, I've witnessed Summer prioritize everyone else's happiness, but today we get to honor her. I truly cannot think of someone more deserving than you. Ty, I have to admit, I may be a little bit jealous, as I realize now, because I haven't before, that you two are more than just lovers, but also best friends. But today, and today only, I'm happy to share this role with you. Never again, though, so don't forget me. I see how happy you make Summer, and I know you'll never hurt her, or else I'll probably have to hurt you, so you better not. But Ty, on a serious note, I want to say thank you for being Summer's person. I love you both, and cannot wait for your future babies. Not kidding. I'm okay with this being sooner than later. Considering. So,
that
yeah, means, I'm there. Thank you, someone's on my side. Let's raise our glass to the bride and groom as we wish them a lifetime of love and happiness. All right, now let's party.
Dreaming of you. What if the wind could spread your love? What if your sweetness could reach everyone? There'd be no wars. High school when they met, and things got kinda awkward. With sparks in the air, he would stare at her in class, and she would try to act cool. But it was obvious, like, ooh, they would be together, ooh. And one day she said, write me a love song, 'cause I know you'll make it beautiful. And maybe I'll call you my sweetheart, and promise nobody can steal me away. Then I am yours, 'cause I want you, and I wanted you to know. He looked at her and then he smiled, picked up a pen and paper, and started writing. Probably something about her eyes and how they're always shining, or something cliche like, ooh, baby, I only want you. It's true. And then he said,
the answer, you're raise your hand. Maybe your partner's the answer, you're raise your partner too. We're gonna see which couple we get him in tonight. And it goes like this. Who made the first move? Ow! Yeah! He's got to think about it. Hold on. Who made the first move? He didn't answer. Raise it up. There you go. And they said each other. Okay. Who was more nervous about tonight? He said both. He said, okay, okay. Who will be the first to fall asleep tonight? All right. How's that? Very good. Who holds their liquor better? He doesn't want to answer. All right. Who's a better driver? Who is more creative? All right. They're both themselves. All right. Who said I love you first? Who said I love you first? He said her, and there he goes. He reluctantly answered. Who's more likely to lose their phone? I shouldn't even know where it is right now. All right. Who's a bigger baby when they're sick? They both said him. He said both. All right. Who is messier? Who is messier? They both said her. Very good. Who's in charge of the TV remote? They both said him. Very good. Who is more patient with the other? Who is more patient? He's thinking about it. Okay. Who's more likely to wake up grumpy? Who's more likely to wake up grumpy? Wow, he's brave, isn't he? He said both and she said her. Very good. Who's more likely to get lost?
Yes.
They both said her. All right. Who's more likely to be running late? He's got a look. They both said him. All right. Who's the first to say I'm sorry? There you go. Smart man. Smart man. Who steals all the covers? And they both said her. Very good. Who is better with money? She's thinking about it. She said both and he said her. All right. Who is more adventurous? They both said themselves. All right. And lastly, who do you love most in the whole world?
Aww.
He's thinking about it. There you go. Let's give him a big round of applause, guys. Let's give him a big round of applause. Y'all can get your shoes back on.
Grabbed his arm and took his hand. He held her close under the moonlight as they kept on dancing. And now they're singing their love song, and they sing it kind of beautiful, calling each other sweetheart. I promise nobody can get in their way or steal the show. They're in love now, and I wanted you to know.